Hello all, welcome to the Pandas for Pentesters course at Pentester Academy. Now in this video, we'll continue with the Airodump NG scan analysis. So let's jump right in. Okay. Now, of course, when we are doing so many scans and we find all of these APs, then the question arises, which one is closest to us? Now, this is really where the DB power column denotes that. Now, keep in mind that just one single reading does not necessarily convey something. What we are trying to look at is the overall trend over time. But assuming that this is kind of an average value, which Airodump doesn't give us, but I'm just assuming that this is an average value, we might be able to estimate how close we might be to some of these APs. So the first thing to check is if there are any spurious values. Sometimes when Airodump is unable to detect the power, it actually uses -1, which in a DBM scale is massively high. Right, so the good news is there aren't any spurious power levels. Now let's go ahead and sort the BloomU data frame using DB power from basically the highest power level to the lowest power level, right? Now keep in mind in DBM, the less negative something is, the higher the power is, right? So -22 is actually greater than -27. Which is the case for negative numbers anyway. So let's move on. So let's go ahead and plot this. And there we go. We have a massive graph. Now, what this is for basically all these different BSS IDs. Going ahead and announcing BloomU, this is the one which is the BSSID 10-8CCF-B4-B2-EA has the highest amount of power, right? And the one we definitely shouldn't target is the one here on the top, which seems to have basically a much more lower power. Now, the problem with this scale is this has plotted everything linearly. Now, log scales, of course, cannot be linearly or should not be linearly plotted and interpreted. So what I've done here is converted it to the appropriate regular linear scale so that now you can look at how it looks like at a simple base 10 system. So here you go. We can clearly see that there is a massive difference between 10-8-8CCF-B4-E2-EA and this one over here, which wasn't that evident if you looked at this graph. Right? If you looked at this graph, it wasn't that evident. Okay, now let's actually do an analysis of when different access points were actually discovered. So if we looked at the D types, you recall we had made first seen and last seen as dates, right? Date time objects. So now let's go ahead and sort these by the first seen. There we go. We can clearly see that almost in the very same second, almost the first 11 of them got detected, right? At 11:20:07. Of course, Airodump NG is a program. It's going to work really fast, right? Unlike a human being trying to observe things. And then after that, you have the 08, the very next second. This is the maximum resolution we have, right? Up to a second, not beyond. So the first thing I'm going to do is, this isn't very useful. If I wanted to plot this, this doesn't even mean anything. What I really want to plot is when I start collecting the trace file, after how many seconds am I kind of getting, you know, the APs. So to do that, what I really require is the time offset or the time delta, right? So what I'm doing is I'm subtracting the first scene line, which a column which we have here, from the very first value, right? Because we have already ordered this in this way, this is the smallest time. And this is now going to be subtracted from every single observation so that we get relative to start of collection of trace. So this is what we have done here. The dot log 0 is really the first value. Okay, let me scroll down. That's some very long file. Okay, so here we are. And of course, I want to convert that into seconds. So let's look at this. Now look at the time offset field. We can see clearly see that the for the first 11, this basically would be zero, right? Because all of them pretty much got discovered in the same second resolution. And then after that, the next one becomes one, right? And of course, this is going to continue till however long we actually collected this trace file. So if we look at tail, we would find that the time offset ends at 1362. I think 22 minutes roughly, if you were to divide this by 60. Yeah, roughly 22, 23 minutes. So now, let's go ahead and plot this as a box plot. Now, what am I trying to do here? Different access points were discovered in different seconds, right, after we started the trace. So now there is a distribution, and we would like to understand when most of these were roughly found. Now, the best representation for this in statistics is what we call a box plot. And this line over here, which is typically the median, if I remember, tells you that around 700 seconds, most of these points were kind of discovered, right? An easier way to visualize this, of course, is a histogram, which essentially conveys the same thing, is around 64 to 65 devices were actually found roughly, basically at this point, right? Between 700 to 800 seconds. And we can go ahead and increase the bins more. There we go. And this gives us an even more clearer picture. So what we did is basically that we are looking at this in minutes right now, by dividing the offset by 60. So now this tells us that most things were discovered roughly around the 13th minute, right? Around 62 devices were discovered by that time. But of course, these are intervals, not really kind of, absolute numbers. So what we try to do here is divide this by 60 so that now, just as in the previous case, we get minutes, but then we set the bins to 25 so that now we can look at it roughly from a per minute perspective. There we go. And we see this. Don't worry if some of this statistic part of the box plot and all that, this is something you're aware of. It doesn't matter. I just wanted to add this analysis to show you the power of Pandas and the possibilities and the fact that you can play around with such time series data as well. Okay. So that's all I have in mind for this video. In the next video, which will be a short one and the last on this analysis, we will look at client data and what we can do with it. Thank you. Have a great day ahead.